blush when somebody says your name. In my stomach there's a pain. See you walk in my direction, I go the other way. I start to stutter when I speak. Try to stand but my knees go weak. What's happening to me? In the dark, can you tell me what it means? I lay my head on my pillow, staring out the window, wishing the star for a sign. I get nervous when you call, so I say I'm not home. I see your face and I hear my favorite song. Should I send an email at home? You're the number one topic on the phone. I wonder if you know, or do you have a clue? Yeah. I lay my head on my pillow. You got me staring out the window. We're showing a star for a sign. What's the reason?
Faithful listeners, thank you all so much for joining me this morning on Coffee and Conversation. Coffee and Conversation. I do appreciate it. Let me do this as well. I am grateful that I have great people in my life that are allowing me to be me and becoming great source, whether it's with your time or with your money or with your energy. Thank you all so much for your support. I don't want to go too often without saying that. I do appreciate you all very much. Very, very much. So thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Remember, we're at Black Diamond Lounge on Mondays in Lithonia, Georgia. 5531 North Henry Boulevard in Stockbridge, Georgia. And on Wednesdays, we are at Smokehouse Cigars, 1936 Hosea Williams Drive in Atlanta, Georgia. That's in the Kirkwood area. And of course, on Fridays, we are at Paradise Island in Lithonia, Georgia. So y'all make sure y'all, if you get a chance, come out and see me one, a show or two, if you don't mind. Even if it's just one for one chance, just come out and hang out with me for one night. I would appreciate that. I hope you all had a great Monday and the beginning of your week. I know sometimes we dread our Mondays, but you know, I always look at it this way, I guess, you know, at least I have, God gave me another day. I know Mondays is the worst day of the week for some people, but at least God gave us another day. At least God gave us another day. So thank you all so much. Let's do this. I was thinking the direction of the conversation today is foundation. I want to talk about foundation. I can't think of the lady who died or was murdered in her house by the police a few weeks ago. And her funeral was this past Sunday. And I was able to hear the bishop talk that did the funeral. No. That wasn't that funeral. That was another funeral. The Cummings funeral was this Sunday, this past Sunday. And the bishop that was doing his service, I watched both services. So y'all know how I am. I check out everything. Good morning, Aries. Good morning, Michelle. Good to have y'all on the show. And the bishop that did, that was doing the senator's or representative Cummings' funeral, said a very, very, very good statement concerning Cummings. And he said that one of Cummings' last act was bringing power to church. He brought power to church. And he went on to further clarify what he was saying was, he brought in his death, he brought so many different styles of power. Corporate America, powerful people in corporate America, powerful people in government. And they were all centered around this man at his funeral. And so what he said, he brought power to church. But in saying this, he began to highlight Cummings' background. And one of the things, and this is where I want to go with the topic, one of the things that he said was Cummings had a foundation. He had a spiritual foundation on what he believed. And so today I want to challenge and I want to ask, do you know your own foundation? Do you know what you're standing on? Do you know how and why you have made the decisions in life that you've made? Now, foundation is not just built on. Our foundation is not just built on, just a spiritual background. It's also based on our upbringing. How were you raised? So my question this morning is simply that. Do you know what your foundation is? Do you know what you're standing on? Do you know whose shoulders you're standing on? Do you know what grounds your feet are standing on in order to make you grow? Your foundation. You know, I was saying, I did a word of the week a while ago now, and I talked about my foundation. I think that's what I named it, my foundation. The thing about a foundation of a building, no one sees or acknowledges your foundation, the foundation of a building. No one really says, oh, you know, that must be on a strong foundation. Oh, that building right there, they don't think about the foundation. Your foundation, however, is the most important part of a building. It's the most important part of a building. But nobody sees it. Nobody is there when they scope out a piece of land to build a place. No one sees anything. You only have a few people around that's walking around the woods and scoping out the area. Say, okay, we're going to build here. And then when they decide to build here, only they add a couple more people to help knock down the trees and remove the dirt. And when it's time to pour the foundation, there is only a few people around to see the hole that is dug, to see the concrete that is laid. It is only after the foundation is set that people begin to see the building take form. And the building that is taking form is all based on the foundation of the building. Now, we could take that and apply it to our lives and how we were how our upbringing was, how our spiritual walk is. We begin to look and see a person by looking at a person, by just simply paying attention to their actions, who they are, what they're doing. You can just about tell what their foundation is, or if they have adjusted the building on a foundation. Now, because I don't want to get too crazy with this, because sometimes the building that we have placed on our foundation is not what our foundation is capable of holding. It can hold more. You can be more. What I mean by that is this: I understand that in life we're not going to be perfect. We're not. We're going to have to make some changes and adjustments as we grow. So just because you see a person at a certain time don't mean that they don't have a strong foundation. They just don't understand or understand how strong their foundation is and to build on. You could tell a building, you know, when the storms, especially hurricanes come, they often worry about buildings because they said, we don't know how strong the foundation of the house is. When you go buy a house, when you go out to buy a house, the house may look beautiful. The house may look beautiful. But when the inspector come in, one of the very first thing they check is the foundation of that building. And the building may look beautiful, but we'll turn around and say this house is no good because of the foundation. When you go to remodel or to build up on your or up on the existing building, you first have to ask yourself, does my foundation support this? Can my foundation that the building that I want to make, the improvements that I want to make, the growth that I want to make, does my foundation, is my foundation capable of handling this? If not, you have to strengthen your foundation. This foundation thing that we should be considering in our lives. The bishop asked the people, the politicians, will crumble on a weak foundation. That is so true. Aries. The bishop asked the politicians, do you remember your foundation? You have all of this power. And I don't want to say it was a political move, but I think it needed to be said. Who you are in D.C., are you operating based on your foundation? Is the character that you're showing, is the way that you answer, is it based on your foundation? Or have you forgotten the foundation in which you operate in? We could take it down to the simplest of who we are and what we do in life. Think about your foundation. And ask yourself, do I have my foundation in check? You listen to Coffee and Conversation with your boy J-Mad on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and all the other platforms that we're on. Even Alexa can make it do what it do.
Chaka 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 Khan, Chaka Khan, Chaka Khan, Chaka Khan, Chaka Khan. Let me rock it, let me rock it, Chaka Khan. Let me rock it, that's all I wanna do. Chaka Khan, let me rock it, let me rock it, Chaka Khan. Let me rock it, got a feel for you. Chaka Khan, what you tell me what you wanna do? Do you feel for me the way I feel for you? Chaka Khan, let me tell you what I wanna do. I wanna love you, wanna hug you, wanna squeeze you too. And let me take it in my arms, let me feel you with my charm, Chaka. Cause you know that I'm the one that keep you warm, Chaka. I make it more than just a physical dream. I wanna rock you, Chaka, baby, cause you make me wanna scream. Let me rock it, rock it.
Listening to Coffee and Conversation with your boy J-Man on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and all the other platforms that we're on. Even Alexa can make it do what it do. We're talking about our foundation this morning. And if we are we who we say we are based on our foundation. Before we went off air, to the musical break, Aries made this. Let me do this. I didn't say good morning to the people that joined in. Michelle, good morning. Aries, good morning. Jackie, good morning. Sherry, good morning. And to those that do not get in the chat room, good morning to you all as well. Aries made a statement, that's a man in a mirror moment. And we're talking about foundation and am I living up to what my foundation is? Aries then went on to say during a musical break, she said, do I represent my foundation? So let's start right there. Do I represent my foundation? Do I represent my foundation? A lot of times, especially with certain companies, when they are at a certain amount, they will build the foundation. They will lay a foundation down. Watch this, with the expectation of growth. I'll say that again. There are certain people in place, even I think they do it with homes as well. They would build a foundation with the expectation of growth. So just because your house looks good at this moment, you have to ask yourself, am I built for more than just this? Am I built for more than just this the building that I'm at? What is my foundation? Is the foundation of what I was built on? My upbringing, my spiritual walk with God, the life experiences that I've learned. Now that I'm grown, now that I've somewhat done figured life out, the building that I live in, can it handle more? Michelle says, I didn't realize how strong my foundation was until it was tested and proven strong. That's a good point. Life teaches that. Most of us are standing only because of our foundation, but what we're building on this foundation. But what are we building on this foundation? Do we, Aries continues, do we build the intended dwelling of the right foundation? Right. Jack says, my foundation has always started with God. I can't build anything without him. So when we talk about our foundation, spirituality is the strong ingredient to a foundation. Remember, a foundation is, biblically speaking, God said, upon this rock I will build my church. God chose a person, a place, a gave an identity. I'm gonna build my church on this principle. People look at it, oh, he's talking about Peter himself, but it was a principle on the inside of who Peter was, that God was building, that Jesus was building the church. My foundation was not strong, and I proud myself tearing it down and in order to start over. That's good. Thank you for joining, Aries. Have a great, blessed day. And Sherry just said something very important. Because watch this. There are some spiritual things that we were taught. There were some things that our parents and the people that were supposed to be the stewards of our upbringing and taught us different things. That as we got older, we had to go back and break some things down. I think that was Sherry that said that. We had to go back and break some things down. Even in this age that we live in now. You know, I'm big on teaching, especially from the church pulpit, that there were certain things that we was not taught right in the church. And so even your spiritual upbringing had to be challenged and revamped and redone. So the foundation of who we are, there's certain things that has to be checked, removed, redone, in order for us to be who we are designed to be. We have to remove some ideologies. We have to remove some things that we were taught in our upbringing, in order to really be who we are purposed to be. We should be able to see, if we're honest with ourselves, if we are really honest with ourselves, and I think it was Aries that may have said it, that look in the mirror moment. That I'm talking to the man in the mirror, that person that I look at in the mirror. Can I be honest? And we talked about this on our shows last week, about looking in the mirror and being honest with what we see in the mirror, because there are certain things that we were taught that honestly was not right. My mom gave me a great spiritual foundation. She taught me that God should be the main ingredient to the building of any foundation. I found my foundation was built by others. Allowing others to detect from being, tearing it down, allowed me to rebuild, and I am much better place. Amen. It takes a lot. It takes a lot to look around us and who we are, and not just around us, within us, and look at the choices that we're making, and look at the people that we're choosing to have to be in a relationship with. I'm not talking about love, just love relationship. I'm including lovers, but I'm talking about friendship. I'm talking about the jobs. I'm talking about friends. I'm talking about the different types of relationships we're in. Is the things around me and how I treat myself, how I'm treating others. If I was to look at my foundation, because watch this, my foundation is about me, which means that anybody that I now allow to enter into the building that I live in, watch this. If I am not taking care of the house that's sitting on a foundation, anybody that enters my space is subject to being hurt because my foundation is not where it needs to be. And so people become endangered by our lack of taking care of ourselves. Just pay attention on how we are hurting. And I don't want to look at it from the outside in, how people are hurting. I'm big on trying my best to make myself better. And this whole conversation today is about making myself better. And I want all of us to be in a position where we say, I'm making myself better. I think society has got us so caught up in building the external that they have forgot to build inside of them first. So I am big on the foundation, that anybody that now enters my space, is safe because I decided to check my foundation. That way I can make sure anything that I build, anything, when I build a family, when I build my business, when I build this, when I build that, when I build the organizations that I'm in, all of that stuff, because my foundation is where it needs to be. Anything. And so when now, when people connect with me, they are also safe with me. When people could, and I think that's a good conversation to have. When people connect with me, they should feel safe with me. Because I did what I needed to do, that places where my foundation was weakened, went back and redid that part of the building. I strengthened that foundation. And that's what they do when you buy houses. And if you really, really want, I don't know if you all watch the do-it-yourself television home improvement shows and stuff like that. When they talk about a house that has a bad foundation, what they say is, I have to strengthen the foundation. I have to strengthen the foundation and make the foundation better, stronger. Because anything that I'm getting ready to do now, in order to make this building make code, be up to standard, the Bible tells us that he will raise a standard. In order to raise the standards of this house, the foundation has to be set. The foundation has to be good. The foundation has to be on point. Because they're with life and with technology, with technology, new things come along. There are better ways of doing things. Now, if we only rely, watch this, if we only rely on, for me, if I only relied on what my grandmama and granddaddy taught me and just stuck right there, the building that I stand on could not be built. Who people see in me could not be built. I had to go further. Yes, it was part of the ingredient, but I need with the new technology, the new way of even studying God's word. You know, back then they can only rely on so much because especially in the black community, we didn't do exegesis of the scripture. We didn't do hermeneutics and stuff like that. Now, each and everybody has the ability to do those things with Google. You can study. The Bible tells us to study to show your own self approved. So we have to take what our foreparents taught us and then make it stronger. Make it stronger. If you lose everything today, is your foundation strong enough where you are able to survive? I'll do it even a better way, Jackie. I was hoping that you was going to say it this way. If you was to lose everything today, is your foundation strong enough to rebuild? Can you rebuild if you was to lose everything? Watch this. There are storms that go through and damage these houses, especially on the coast, on the East Coast, especially down there in the Gulf, Texas area. Watch this. The whole building is gone. But guess what stays there? The foundation. Guess what they're able to build on? The foundation that's there. That's why I believe we should always put God first, because this stuff is temporary if we build. Yes. God should be the foundation, but our foundation is more than God. We put so much on this, we're made up of three things: mind, body, and spirit. All three things should be the essential part of our foundation. How we take care of ourselves physically is part of our foundation. How we take care of ourselves emotionally is part of our foundation. If it's not balanced right, if those three ingredients are not balanced right, then our foundation will be weakened. If we don't understand that all three are just as important, God is the strengthening agent. God is the strengthening agent. However, our foundation is included in the three things that God made us. He made us to be a body, He made us to have a mind, and He made us to have a spirit. And so, how we take care of ourselves physically. So, are we taking care? We'll just go here with it. Are we taking care? A lot of people, especially us black folks, we're good at going to church and getting some good word in us and making our spirit man strong. And what we neglect is to go sit on somebody's couch and make our mind strong. What we neglect is to take our medicine. I'm stepping on my own toes. And making my body stronger. And God has given us all of that. Without Him, we have nothing. Amen. That's why I suggested that God is the strengthening agent for everything. It is the glue that holds us together. He is the glue that binds us together. You know, because part of the my granddaddy, he used to have this powdery substance that he used to go buy to make the cement, but he also would take dirt and put it in the cement, and then he would turn. Oh, that's good preaching right there. He would take dirt and put it in, that's life, and put it into the cement mix. And then when he put dirt into the cement mix, he had to, how am I going to bind this stuff together? He would add water and mix it and stir it all together. He would stir the cement stuff together. He would stir the sand together. And when he stirred the sand together, and the cement to get the cement mixed together and the water together, it became stiff, but it also became, watch this, pliable. In order to build a perfect foundation, you must be pliable first. You must be willing to be shaped into what you are to become. The foundation demonstrates the object in which the building is going to initially look like. And so, in order for them to make that foundation, they would put up stakes in the ground and line it up. And the dirt that they dug the hole would be the shape of the building. And so, the when they poured it in, the cement would fill. When if it was a turn, the cement would turn. It would bend. So we must be pliable. And then once they poured the cement, you could not immediately start building. You couldn't start building. I would go back and talk about how they put the wrought irons in the foundation and the purpose of the wrought iron, but that's going too far and too deep with it. But watch this. When they poured it, they could not do it. They couldn't start building. You had to wait for time. That's life. That's called life. That's called life. We have to apply the knowledge God has given us. Knowing and not applying it doesn't work. Yes. we have to allow time to take place to strengthen us. So let me tell you what that means. When we rebuild, when things happen to us in life and God is going to reshape us and remodel our foundation, it takes time to heal. I'm feeling good right in through here. It takes time to heal. If you're rushing into different relationships, from one relationship to the next relationship, and I'm not just talking love relationship, I'm talking any relationship, it takes time for that new foundation, because you learn some things. Life experiences will teach you some things. And when you are taught and when you learn those lessons, what you do is you're strengthening your foundation by applying those things to your foundation. And it's making your foundation. Watch this, because we think we started building early on in life. No, we were still building on our foundation early on in life. Now, God, many of us are in a place where God is really, that's where I am, the blessing that God is doing for me. The platform that God has me on now is built on a foundation that deals with a lot of hurt. It deals with a lot of growth. It deals with a lot of life experiences. Now God says, now I'm ready to build what you are here for. So when I look back over my life, and I think things, I'm sorry, I got caught up in the song. We sit and we wonder, what was all of that about? God is getting ready to make what all of that was about. He's going to show you what your building is going to look like now. We're at an age where God is building that now. He's building on the foundation now. And if we're too busy, if we have not healed, if we have not thrown away certain things in our lives, it will make our foundation, it will make the building weaker. So make sure we got all of the impurities out of our foundation, so now God can start building on what he has purpose for us to be. You're listening to Life Out There, Coffee and Conversation with your boy J-Mad. Y'all join me every Tuesday and Thursday, 8 a.m. We'll be back. I'll let your boy.
It's
You listen to Coffee and Conversation with your boy J-Mad on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and all the other platforms that we're on. Even Alexa can make it do just what it do. Our foundation, as we do this last set here, one of my desires is for us to be perfectly honest with ourselves when it comes to who we are, what we have, and where we're going. The things that we went through. One of the things that I've learned in life is the reason why we go through a lot of tests, or reason why God put us through a lot of tests, and it seems like it's the same test over and over again, is because we hadn't learned the lesson from before. All those lessons that God has been teaching us through these years was in preparation of our foundation. It was in preparation of our foundation. So while we thinking, I'm in my 40s or whatever, we're thinking that that's been a lifetime. To God, that's only a second. They said 1,000 years is a day to God. 1,000 years is one day to God. So we haven't even lived a whole day in God's mindset or greater scheme of things. So if that be true, God is just beginning with us. Don't rush the process. What I mean by that is sometimes when you're building your foundation, sometimes you're going to have to go back and correct some things, because something, it didn't turn out right. It didn't fall the way it needed to fall. It didn't solidify itself the way it needed to solidify. Maybe you have forgotten to put this part of what needed. Oh, you know what? We were supposed to put in a drainage system. Oh, we were supposed to put in these spikes here and the cement. So I'm gonna have to break down the cement and redo the cement so I could put these spikes in, because you were supposed to have this in the house or in the building. The building was supposed to do this, and so the building people looked at the blueprints and say, oh, you know what? I really want to add this. And so they have to go back and redo the foundation. Just because we're looking pretty now, just because we survive some things now, does not mean that there is still not work to do on our foundation. God may be finished with your foundation. I'm not saying that he's not. But please be pliable enough that if God wants to change some things in you, that you will be able to be pliable enough to go through it, to reshape the foundation, to make the foundation, because sometimes it's not even about making the foundation stronger. Sometimes it's about making the foundation bigger. Because y'all, let me help y'all out with one of y'all prayers then that y'all pray. God, enlarge my territory. If God is going to enlarge your territory, guess what God is going to have to do? Build you a whole nother foundation. He's going to have to build you a whole nother. It's not that foundation that you're on is not strong enough. But when you say, God, enlarge my territory, that means that you're going to have to give God room enough in your life to take more space up. That's why, you know, especially when you're considering ministry things. When you're considering ministry things, I'm going to help you all out. Peter taught, Paul taught, he said, I would that you not be married. Because if you're married, the space that I need, that God needs to use in your life, is now going to be taken up by a relationship. Because watch this. The marriage was built before the church. So the large part of your foundation is going to be based on your relationship or your marriage. I would that you not be married. So when you get out here saying, God enlarged my territory, understand that you're going to be broken down again. This is what you all are saying when you pray this prayer. God, break me again. Remove a whole bunch of stuff out of my life that I wanted. So that you can dig up some ground and lay another foundation. So be very, very, very mindful of what we are asking God when we're saying these prayers. If you want to be in a relationship, understand that there's a lot of stuff in ministry you can't do. That's why I am where I am right now. Because my focus is on the ministry part of me, what I'm doing with Life After the Collar. I'm the relationship part. I'm not trying to be in a relationship. Don't desire to be in a relationship. Because I know where my focus is. I know where my energy, my focus is going to be on. Sooner or later, yeah, I may get settled down to a point where I got everything up and running the way it needs to be up and running and it's flowing the right way. I may decide to do that later. But right now, that's not me. And I think we all should be real enough to understand when you are focused on building, on your foundation or getting your foundation together, please be mindful that your foundation is all about you. It's not about anybody else. It's all about you. So as we think this week and we take this seed that we heard today on the show and things that God was showing me about me, I hope that we learn that God, here am I, use me. But we should go, God, here am I, now show me me. And when y'all say, God, show me me, not only show me what you're going to do in my life, show me all of the stuff that you, that's on the inside of me that I got to get rid of. I think that God sometimes wants us to be alone for a season so we can do what God has purposed. Jackie, you have, that is the greatest statement that I've ever heard. That's one of the greatest statements that I've ever heard. I think sometimes God wants us to be alone for a season so we can do what God has purposed us to do. God wants us to be alone because he wants that relationship, his relationship, your relationship and him, to be good, strong, strengthened. We all said that God is based on the foundation that we have. It has a lot to do with God. How strong is your relationship with God? And it should show also your, not only your spirit side, because your spiritual side is so strong, it should make you take care of your body. It should make you take care of your mind. If you're doing your relationship with God first. Because the Bible talks about how our bodies is a temple. And if we're not taking care of our bodies, something is wrong. The Bible teaches us about our minds and how our mind's supposed to be operating a certain way. That's why He said he never told us it's not okay to drink, but he said it's okay. It turns bad and it becomes a sin when you get drunk and you can't take care of yourself. And mentally you're out of it. Weigh your relationship with God. And if you're not taking care of yourself emotionally and physically, You need to go check your relationship with God. Because are you hearing God? God should be telling you. You should hear God telling you. You need to take care of your body. I hear all the time. And sometimes I ignore it. I got to improve. God literally tells me, Jason, take your medicine. I literally hear God tell me that. I hear when God tell me, Jason, you need to slow down and think about that. And when I slow down and think about that, you will see me go back. And if I've done something because I was in my emotions, I learned to go back and apologize. So my mind, your mind has to be right. Your body has to be right. And your spirit has to be right. Your foundation is so important because I believe all of us, God wants to begin to build now. I think all of us are at an age. I'm literally talking to the ones that was on the show, that was in the chat room. I'm not sure all of those that was listening in, that didn't say anything in the chat room, but I believe that all of us, I know my age group of people that listen to the show. I have a certain age group. I think all of us, I feel that all of us are at a place where God really wants to build. He really wants to build something that's mind blowing, that when people see you, their mouths are going to drop open, like that commercial with the truck that tailgate do what it does. Take time to love on you. Take time to heal from old hurts and wounds. Don't try to replace something over something that has yet healed. And you could tell by people's conversation if they're healed or not. Because certain stuff still bothers them. If you're still bothered by something, then you're not healed. That's an indication you're not healed. It's just like a cut on my ankle. I can look on my ankle and I have a scar. I see the scar, but I touch it. I don't feel any pain. When I think about the surgery and the stuff that I went through, I cannot remember the pain. I just know I went through it, but I can't remember any of the hurt behind it. If something reminds you of something in your past, you are not healed. Thank y'all so much for joining me this morning on Coffee and Conversation. I really, really, really enjoyed having you all on the show. Again, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I'll let you, boy. It's all good. It's definitely, definitely all gravy. I'm going to be at Smokehouse tomorrow, 5531 Hosea Williams in Atlanta, Georgia. Y'all be good. Talk to you later.